Here's a list of 9 hidden and underrated features in DaVinci Resolve 19. Some tricks to help you edit faster, some tips to help you get better results, and some hacks to make life while editing just a little bit easier. Here we go. So printer lights actually refers to a method of adjusting the tint and white balance in the old days, the film days, by shining colored light on the film. But now in DaVinci Resolve, it's just a way to quickly and easily adjust the tint and white balance of your image. How does it work? Well, in the color page, go to color and then enable the printer lights hotkeys here. And now you can use the numeric keypad on your keyboard to adjust the tint and white balance of your image, basically by adjusting the offset wheel, this one. And here you can see what each key does. And here's a visual representation, what it looks like on your keypad. And so let's say I want to add red to the image, right? You could do that by dragging the offset dot here towards red, but it's not very accurate because as you can see here, I'm already adding and subtracting other colors too. Now, another way is to just put the mouse over one of the colors here and then drag left or right. But by far the easiest and quickest way is to use the printer light hotkeys. For example, 7 to add red and 4 to subtract red. And if you hold the Option or Alt key, the increments will be smaller. And if you're not happy with the result, just hit Shift and the Home key and everything will reset. So for colorists, the scopes are the most important tool for getting information on what their image actually objectively looks like. And you always have them available here in the color page. But what if you want to see them in the edit page? Or maybe you want to see more than one at the same time. Well, just go to Workspace, Video Scopes, turn Video Scopes on, or down here, use this expand icon. And there we go, the scopes will pop up in a separate window. That's also available in the edit page. And you can make it bigger and smaller and show different scopes at the same time. And ideally, of course, especially if you want to show all the scopes at the same time, you put the scopes on a second screen. So DaVinci Resolve has a bunch of built-in effects and animated titles. Some are cool, some are less cool. But there's actually a way to adjust and tweak them to make them look exactly the way you want. So whenever you add an effect or animated text, so let's say this video call effect, right? Well, just drop it on the timeline and then you can adjust a few settings here in the inspector window, like the color of the call button or the format of the time code. But what if I want to change the size of the call button or the font of the time code? Well, all you need to do is click this button here and then Resolve will take you to the Fusion page. And here you'll see a node containing all the tools they use to create that effect, the video call effect, or the animated title you chose. And then just double click on it and then it will show you everything that's inside, every tool. And now you can just adjust whatever you want. For example, the font of the timecode here, or the size of the call button, just by adding a transform node. Now, it's definitely not easy. You have to know your way around Fusion and keyframes and nodes, but if you're a little bit adventurous, you could try creating your own custom effect by tweaking an existing built-in effect. And if you're not adventurous, but you still want super cool motion graphics, effects, and animated titles, well, then maybe you should check out MotionVFX, the sponsor of this video. I use MotionVFX plugins, effects, motion graphics, and animated titles for literally every video I make. And of course, I have my favorite ones. You've all seen them in my videos. But the cool thing about MotionVFX is that they add new stuff all the time. For every type of creator, videographer, or cinematographer. Maybe you're making music videos, or documentaries, or just YouTube videos. It doesn't matter. There's something for everyone. Here, check out some of these new additions. M Hi-Tech for when you need something futuristic, or M Tag. And here, M Workspace. All completely different, but equally cool. And all their plugins and titles are super easy to use. Just drag them onto your timeline, adjust the settings, and done. So go check them out after watching this video. The link is in the description. Okay, and now back to the hidden and underrated Resolve features. So you can obviously easily scale, reposition, and crop your image in the inspector window here, just by adjusting these settings. But sometimes an easier way, depending on what you're doing exactly, is to use the overlays here. If you open this drop-down menu, you'll see a bunch of different overlays you can use. For example, transform, and then you can activate and deactivate it by clicking on the icon, see? And this will allow you to move around and scale the image just by clicking and dragging. Same for cropping. Or maybe you want to add a dynamic zoom. Just enable the dynamic zoom overlay. The green rectangle is your starting point and the red one your ending point. So move them to wherever you want and make them however big you want. The smaller you make them, the more it will zoom in. And if the red one is smaller than the green one, obviously you will get a zoom in effect. And if you want to disable the dynamic zoom again, just disable it here in the inspector window, because it will automatically enable there when you use the overlays. And here's a quick tip for all of you who like to work with the curves. So let's say you have a few anchor points. So shadows down, highlights up, and you have another one here in the middle, but you want to adjust this one without lifting or lowering the midtones. So you don't want to affect the tones. Well, just hold the Option key while sliding that anchor point and it will snap to the straight diagonal, see? So now that anchor point won't directly affect the tones of your image. It will affect the shape of the curve depending on what other anchor points you have, but not the tones directly. And here's a super simple feature that I use almost all the time for videos like this. Up here, you can enable the aspect ratio overlays. The ones I use most of the time are center, to check if I'm in the center of the frame, or the safe area guides, when I'm editing a short, for example, just to make sure that all the text and titles are aligned properly and in the safe area, so they won't get cut off or anything like that. Super simple, but super useful. So there are different ways to navigate the timeline in DaVinci Resolve. But by far the easiest and fastest way, if you have a middle mouse button, is just by using that middle mouse button. So all you have to do is click in the timeline using the middle mouse button and then drag left or right. It's a lot faster and more accurate than using the playhead, for example. And it also works in the up and down direction, by the way, if you have multiple tracks. Sometimes when, I don't know, when you're working on a transition, for example, maybe you want to play and loop that part, only that part where the transition is, right? But if you enable the loop feature or the loop button here in the edit page, this icon, it will loop the whole timeline. So it will play the whole timeline till the end and then start from the beginning. That's your loop. But I just want to loop this part here where my transition is that I'm working on. Well, all you need to do then is put the playhead a little bit before the transition, hit the I button to create an endpoint, then put the playhead after the transition, hit the O button to create an out point, and now see it created this little segment here from in to out point. And if you play the timeline now with the loop button enabled, it will only play and loop that short segment. And it also works in the color page, by the way. You just have to enable the timeline here in the color page so you can create an in and out point exactly the same way. Super useful. So depending on where in the editing process you are, your layout, your DaVinci Resolve layout, will probably look different, right? And there's probably certain layouts that you use more than once, or maybe you have favorite layouts. Well, instead of manually adjusting the layout all the time, you could also just save your favorite layouts as a preset. So let's say this is the layout I use every time I start editing a video. Well, just go to Workspace here, Layout presets, and save this layout as a preset. Give it a name, for example, editing phase one, something like that, and done. And now you can load this preset every time you need it. And even if it only saves you just 10 seconds, it's already worth it, because 10 times 10 seconds is 100 seconds, and 10 times 100 seconds is 1,000 seconds. So, you know, yeah. Okay, and that's it for today. Let me know what your favorite feature is or was, and maybe you know some other hidden features that are super useful. Drop it in the comments, and maybe I'll add them in one of my next videos. Thank you so much for watching, and see you in the next one.